G'day guys, and welcome back to episode 3 of Chasing Lines. Now, last week you saw us make our way to the tip of Cape York, coming back down the east coast. Three cars got bogged in the Jardine River and have headed back to Cairns. Left is me and Reese and Shorty and the GU Patrol. We head bush to explore the east coast of the Cape, make our way down seeing Captain Billy's Landing, doing the Frenchman's Track to Chilli Beach, and also down to Cape Flattery area until we meet the others in Cairns. I'd just like to add how I appreciate all the positive response I've got from making these little clips. I enjoy editing this trip of ours, and all the positive feedback just keeps me motivated to finish off the rest, so keep it coming, guys. To Captain Billy's Landing. I left the other boys, they're heading down the PDR back to Cairns, but me and Reese decided to go have a look at Captain Billy's Landing, and then, well, you need a permit to camp there, so we'll pop back in today and probably camp along the Frenchman somewhere. Reese is behind me.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's pretty mad tracks, like, whoop, down, whoop. Down through the Great Dividing Range. Yeah, the Great Dividing Range. Shut up, Reese. Yes.
G'day, guys. on the 21st of August here, and we've just had a split off from the crew, and they've had to go into Cairns to sort some issues out with alternators and other bits and pieces. But there's my car that's still running that everyone thought would be the first to go. And Sammy's all good here, so he's up ahead, and we're going a bush.
Driving on to do the Frenchman's Track and see where we get to, but the other boys are heading down to Cairns now. Hopefully they should be on the road. Frenchman's should be pretty good, and see what the rivers bring us. And there's two main river crossings there, and you cross the Jardine. I think the other one's got a hard bottom, not a sandy like the Jardine did, so pretty easy day I think ahead of us, but have a good day.
window up.
Oh, that's it, mate. What do we make of chips?
How you going, guys? We're making beer battered chips tonight.
Beer battered chips.
At the one and the only Chili Beach. Unfortunately,
no chili.
We've got some pussies over here and they don't like chili, so we won't put any chili flakes in it like I did with my dinner. But what do I go with? 3.5 of these.
Yeah, well, this says for 2 potatoes.
Yep, 3.5 cups of
flour.
Plain flour there, guys.
And about then, that much.
Yep.
Baking powder.
This bloke has already got the teaspoon out for me. Look at that.
Baking powder.
How much baking powder?
The same
powder?
As baking soda, basically. Just about that much.
Half a teaspoon.
The whole lot.
Nah, I'm doing properly.
Half a teaspoon. Is that
a teaspoon, though?
Yeah. No, that's a teaspoon. That's a really small teaspoon, but I'm going a little bit more. Yep. Now give it a little stir. But woo! How you going there? And then, what do we need? We need a spoon to stir it up.
We had one of them. Is that it?
Just getting in my custom made drawers by Dion in South Australia.
Shout out
to Dion. Yeah, and I need 300ml of beer in me beer batter here.
Wow. About the whole
lot. And a can is $3.75, so we might have a bit of a neck out of it first.
Hope you're watching, Mum. In she goes, that's enough.
Nah, a little bit more.
Oh my god. Some for me.
Tastes too good, eh?
Oh, you meant to do a little bit of a stir, but...
Yeah,
oh,
hold on. Right. Whoa.
Yeah, no.
So I'm drinking
meant to be beer batter, not beer and batter.
Fold it. Needs to loosen up a bit, so then we can, like, fold it around the chips and really delicious them up. This recipe was only for 2 potatoes, and we've cut up 5.
Did you cut up 5?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Hang on. Oh no, I only cut up 4, guys, don't worry.
Alright, so how do we get the batter onto the chips? Liam's gonna sacrifice his fingers. You dunk and then into the basket. You're pretty good with your hands, eh, Liam?
Fucking
hell. Right, well,
they're going in. Gentle, if they spit everywhere. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh, nice on fire! What are we gonna do?
Well, once it's overflowed enough, that's alright. That's right. Hectic. She's done, she's ready.
That looks pretty good, I reckon.
What do you reckon?
Yeah, nah, they're pretty good. Ready, Reef? Oh, now they're. Oh no, they're battered to the cage. Well, that one failed a bit, didn't it? We'll get the knife out and we'll chop them off.
We're just gonna poke these through, like. But they're not poking through either. No, oh my god.
Nah, pry it from
cut.
The side.
And.
Yeah, nah, they're still.
They're not too bad.
But they do need to be cooked through a bit more.
Okay, well.
Just arrived at Bathurst Head. Beautiful beach. Check it out.
There
you go, mate.
What's
that doing?
This place is pretty dirty, eh?
Pretty dirty. I don't reckon I'll catch a fish, bro.
Yeah, no, you might catch a crocodile.
I didn't bring a long enough rod, so. Cast,
if you can fit that reel on my rod, you'd go hell far.
I want my beach rod.
Come into my place. The view. Bloody amazing. Alex! Oh my god!
If we catch crabs,
we're gonna be very itchy.
Why?
Oh. Cook her up, get it to the boil, cook them for about 15 minutes.
Cause they're gonna be fucking big.
I think that's a bit long for crabs.
Nah, they're gonna be big.
And then, dip them in sweet chili sauce.
Yeah, no, I don't really want to walk through the bush, eh? Why doesn't it smell like poop?
What the fuck is that?
Ow, it's prickly on my feet.
How are you guys? Here at Bathurst Head, crabbing.
No, I'll chuck it in, mate.
Now, we rocked up on the beach earlier, found some old crab pots, so here we go. And then just fucking wrap around a tree or something special.
So old mate Snee Shine Snappy doesn't fucking.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
That's good.
Yeah.
What? You didn't tie it?
No, because it's got a bottle on it.
Oh. It's alright, mate. We've got this, alright? Yeah, sick. Let's go find another spot for the second net and get some dinner on the go.
Chuck them in the water, because there might be a sheesh nice snappy.
Poor little guy.
Somebody's clipper butt.
Holy sh! Get him!
He's got no clippers, man.
That was. Did it hurt?
No, it's got this club.
Yeah, quick nail.
$140. Have a good laugh, mate.
Fuck, 150 is pretty big, eh?
Yeah.
Outdoor cinema going.
Woohoo! Check it out. How you going, guys? How about this? We've got the bush cinema, iPad, duct tape to the door, and auxiliary cord to surround sound inside the car. You couldn't buy better.
Righto, we're starting our trip.
Sick. And we've even got a footrest.
What?
Which will then enable us to access.
Oh, mate's learning guitar over there. Crab trap. We're doing that.
Wait, dude.
What did you do?
I didn't do it.
I'm gonna fuck him.
Yeah, no, it's still hot.
Ah, yeah.
Oh, no.
Heading towards Melville Beach today. Cape Melville, Camper Crocodile Park. It's
gone through a bit of a windy section here. It's quite... Reese is hungry.
Yeah, no, I was going to mention the same thing, eh? I'll pull up somewhere.
Anyway. Reminds me a lot of a beach, a bit of a vibe. So, you know, you're getting close to the coast, but it's quite a sandy track the whole way. So it's good fun. I'm just going to find somewhere to stop for lunch and have a piss and whatever. And keep going.
How you going, guys? Day one on the Starkey track. Hopefully it's only going to take us a day, but it's pretty bumpy and we've heard word that it might take us longer, but see how we go and just poddle on. There's a few nice views around here with the mountains over on the horizon. We'll just drive down a big hill then. That was a good view. And some cattle on the road just up here, so we have to slow down for these ones. They're coming at me. Shit. Nah, we'll be right. Just go straight through them. Oh, I want to go through that one though. A few biggies there. Alright, better sort these fellas out. Catch us later.
Bit me everywhere. Whoa! All of us. So keep that in mind. Give me a shake. Get me an icy pole. Didn't want to hop out the car out of the aircon. Track is slow.
Our icy pole opening tool.
We are on a Starkey road to Cape Flattery.
Okay, shit road.
Yeah, it's pretty shit. It's slow. We got up early this morning, I mean, fucking 6 o'clock. I reckon 11 hour drive, but it's one of the more remote drives in the Cape. We haven't seen civilization for what, like 3 or 4 days?
3 days,
and we've got another couple more before we hit Hope Vale, then Cooktown. So yeah, self-sufficient. Just us and the bulls, really. There's a shit ton of bulls out there, ramming us and stuff. Meanwhile, back in Cairns.
You know, we're professionals.
Do it often.
Now, this track out to Cape Flattery, I was inspired to do after watching many of the four-wheel drive shows, Four-Wheel Drive Action, All for Adventure. They all seem to go out here and do this track. There's quite a lot of water on there as well, so it was very enjoyable for me and Reese to head out there.
But these are probably all pretty good bass, eh? Good sand. Yeah, that's the one. It's just got a random dip in it.
We'll be right back. Even though these roads are driven often, there's always going to be things in the way. Here we just had to winch a little tree out of the way to get past.
Cooking
chips.
That look alright. Just chips, eh? What type of chips?
Peanut butter.
Oh, alright. Nah, you're doing alright.
It's more like a hash brown, but that'll do.
Yeah. Can't help it when you're out here, can you? It was a bit of a fail the other night, but they're a bit better. Nice.
Now this is the infamous Cape Flattery conveyor tunnel, a square 2.4 by 2.4 meter culvert. Didn't think I was going to make it through with the 10 on top, but 5 psi on the tires gave me the clearance I needed.
Fucking
just fit.
If you air down, we might make it.
This will get me fucking height down.
Look at the trees going hectic.
Oh my god! Liam's taking us to the pub.
Aren't you, Mass?
Yeah.
It's meant to be here.
It's meant to be here. Oh, cool.
I know where the pub is in Cooktown, I need a palmy. Alright, go to the other one.
Yeah, no, nah,
next time on Chasing Lines.
I'm packed and I'm holding. I'm smiling, she lives and she golden. She lives for me. Says she lives for me, ovation. For one motivation, she comes
what do you call this then, mate?
And I'll make it smile like a time for you. Whoever what you wanna do, coming over you. I'll smile when we go through. One spot to the rhythm that divides you. And it's to you like the chorus to the verse. Drop another line like a total with the curse.
Whoa.
Going like a freak show, take the stage. We give them the game, she plays to say, I want something else to get me through this. Send me some kind of life. Baby, baby, I want something else. I'm not listening.